Hello and welcome to the craft tutorial for Musica 8 Volume 28 Number 2, the paper quilling project to accompany the song Redbird. You will find in the graphics and extra section the PDF directions, and these will be very helpful with this project since the project is meant for older students and they'll be able to follow along more easily. So go ahead and print out that PDF and have that in hand. The first page features some background information about quilling, some images of the different shapes that are common in quilling, and then a list of the items that each student will need in order to replicate this project. And full disclosure, I am not a paper quilling expert. These are just, the directions are based on what I found worked for me in order to create this project. So from the PDF directions, your first step right here is to gather your construction paper, and you'll have two sheets of red and one sheet of black, and you'll want to mark out half inch lines across and go ahead and cut all of those out, so you'll have two sheets worth of red strips and one sheet worth of black. You may or may not, your students may or may not use all of the paper depending on how tightly they wind each of the shapes. So keep that in mind. So the first step in creating your bird is to take a full length strip right here. Take a full length strip, create a teardrop shape like so, and tape it on the end. And that's this shape right here, taped up. And then the second is to take a half of a strip, recreate that teardrop shape, tape it on the end, and that creates the head of the bird. So those are the two main shapes that you're going to be filling in. You'll next take a half a strip of your black and do the teardrop shape, and that is going to be the wing of the bird. I kind of laid it out the way that I wanted all the shapes to look for the bird. And then lastly, before you start quilling all of the main red shapes, you'll take one full strip of black and create a coil, and this coil will become the bird's eye. And to show you how I did the coils, so you take your strip of paper, and I took a paper clip and you kind of wind it around, and once you get it going, it'll kind of fold in on itself, and then just like so, and you'll wind it all the way up. And once the paper is wound on itself, you'll take it off of the paperclip and take your fingers and kind of rub back and forth and push on the paper at the same time. And what you're doing is you're making the paper kind of bend into the shape that you want it to bend into. So you keep doing this, and after a little while, the paper, it will keep that shape instead of uncoiling immediately. So there you go, that's how I did the eye. For the S shape, which is the main, I'm gonna see if you guys can see it in the video, the main part of the body and the inside of the wing and the head are just comprised of a whole bunch of the S shapes, so, or scroll shapes. And so here's one that I created with one full strip of paper, and here is one with, I'm gonna get to the half a strip tightly wound. So as you can see, depending on how much you press on the paper, you can make larger or smaller shapes. So I'll show you how I did the S shape with a full strip of red. You'll take your paper clip, and again, kind of take your finger, pinch the paper onto the paper clip, and roll it until it catches on itself, and then roll in this one direction about halfway down the paper, like so. Then I flip, and then I take and work the coil from the other direction. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and rub, push on this to make it keep its shape. And then on the other side, I'm gonna take and roll. And roll it all the way down. And again, these, it might be kind of hard to see in the video, but there are some close-up pictures in the PDF that should be helpful in recreating this. But at least in the video, you can see how it is that I'm pressing on the paper. So you have that, the, you know, that's backwards. You have the S shape, and you just wanna pinch and press, and when you do that enough times back and forth, it'll end up keeping the shape. So then this is a full sheet S. So then you'll make a whole bunch of these and you'll place them throughout the inside of the red bird. And so you'll place a whole bunch of shapes and you'll end up moving stuff around and interlocking them and maybe squishing them. And you'll have a little bit of time to have to play around with the shapes to get them the way that you want. But once you have it filled in the way that you like, then you're going to take the liquid glue and you're going to just drop all throughout your sculpture. You're gonna wanna drop the liquid glue. And you're gonna wanna make sure that some of the glue gets to the bottom of the sculpture so it sticks to your background paper. So, and you'll need to give yourself at least a day to have that dry before you try to hang these up. But don't forget to do, if you'd like, you can do a little tuft of feathers on the top here, some legs and little birdie feet, and then I did a little birdie tail. That kind of gives you an idea of what you can do to recreate this project. Thank you so much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed it.